Mr. and Mrs. North, starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning.
Husband about this first.
Well, that depends on how much you want to take our course, Mrs. North, and how understanding your husband is.
Oh, Jerry is very understanding. But I think I better surprise him. Now, you understand, I'm not interested in becoming a professional model, Don Santiago.
Of course. We have many ladies like yourself who take our course because they understand the value of training in grace and poise. Though we rarely have the pleasure of one with such natural talents.
Well, thank you.
Miss Loomis, we'll show you around and introduce you to our faculty.
This way, Mrs. North.
Change engagement. Change again. Repeat. Repeat again. Advance now. Advance once more. Change again. Extend your arm. Lunge. That, stretch your left leg there, stretch and left hand. This stretch and the foot flat on the floor. Come back on guard again. That's now, repeat again. That's it now, have
none. Oh, Robert, I'm so terribly ashamed to be coming to you again. You've helped me out so many times.
Darling, if I only had it, I don't even know where I could borrow that much money.
Oh, I understand. It is a lot of money.
Extend arm again.
After all, Mother's only six.
Hi, Cal.
It's not as though it were a matter of life or death.
Oh, Ellen, please don't. Don't, darling. I'll get the money somehow.
Okay.
Repeat again. Advance now. Advance once more.
Mrs. North is one of our new pupils, Darlene.
Gee, Mrs. North, if I can help you anyway, just give a yell. Only, maybe I better not.
Darlene is exactly our most promising pupil.
But I'm getting better, Miss Loomis. Watch.
Well, at least the book didn't fall. She's very attractive. She wants to be a fashion model, but I'm afraid we're fighting nature.
Oh, do I get to do that, too?
Yes, of course. Both Don Santiago and I feel that fencing and ballet are an excellent foundation to give you confidence and a grace of movement.
Then the lunge, pari quatre riposte. Nine, nine, after the pari comes the riposte. The counterattack, here. Attack me. Now, first comes the pari, then comes the riposte. The counterattack, you understand?
Oh, Carl.
That'll be all.
Carl, I'd like to have you meet someone. Mrs. North, this is Carl Werner, our fencing master. He was three weapons champion at Heidelberg.
Three weapons?
The foil, the épée, and the sabre.
Catch me how to use one of those things?
Why, of course, Mrs. North. I have never failed. Failed only once. Ach, that darling. 6 months of lessons, and she still thinks that a beaten septime is some new kind of boogie-woogie.
Mrs. Loomis, I'm sorry. I didn't see you.
Hurry.
I hope I didn't hurt you. Why, you bum.
No, enough. Stop it. Myra, it was only an accident. She did not see you.
You really should be more careful, Ellen. Even with a button tip, that foil could be dangerous.
She hates me.
No, Ellen, don't be foolish. Myra was just upset.
Oh, Carl, you know I wouldn't hurt anybody.
Of course, I know that.
Carl, you're so wonderfully understanding.
Regard, Robert, the Mecca, into which we send the most beautiful models in the world.
You've been reading your own brochures again.
But you don't believe in what we are...
Oh, look, Santiago, stop avoiding the subject. I came here to get an advance on my salary.
Yes, a rather large one. You said you needed it for...
I didn't say. But it so happens it's for Ellen.
Ellen? Strange.
Well, what's so strange about it? She needs my help.
No, I don't think so.
You mean I don't get an advance?
I mean that Ellen doesn't need your help.
And what does that mean?
It's obvious that subtlety is lost on you, Robert. So let me make it very clear. In the future, whatever Ellen's problems are, I'll take care of them.
You?
Me. She'd prefer that. So you see, Robert, you don't need that advance after all.
No. You're lying.
Am I?
Well, you'd better be. Ellen and I love each other.
Robert, you're a good photographer and a fine teacher. But I'm afraid you've jumped to a childish conclusion because of Ellen's friendliness.
The only conclusion I've jumped to is that I don't get the advance. But I'll get the money. And if try to come between Ellen and me, I'll...
You'll kill me? Not you, Robert. You don't have the nerve.
Santiago... You could be wrong about my nerve.
What was troubling Robert?
I had just delivered a short lecture on the proper relationship between the faculty and our student body.
Oh?
Yes, I noticed that Robert was taking a too personal interest in one of the girls. I told him that we couldn't countenance that sort of thing.
Well, you're right. We can't.
We should also have a rule, Myra, that we don't listen at doors.
Loomis.
Yes?
Well, Miss Loomis, I'm worried.
Worried?
You, Darlene?
Oh, I know I'm typed as the happy dumb blonde, but I can still see things.
Darlene, what on earth are you talking about?
It's Ellen. Her playing around with the men here. I'm not just being catty, Miss Loomis. I've seen the way she operates. And believe me, if these men ever get together...
Thank you, dear. I'm really greatly touched by your concern, but I'm sure we can handle the situation.
Try to fix this darn thing for me. Oh, no. All right, darling, what is it? Charades?
A parry and a thrust.
Oh. What?
Fencing talk.
The book on your head. Are you trying to read it by osmosis?
Poise.
What? No, wait a minute. While the spell is broken, talk to me, darling, huh?
It's very simple, Jim. Of course, in modeling.
Why?
Don't you want a model wife?
I've got a model wife.
Oh, Jerry, how sweet.
No, I'm not sweet. I'm curious. Or make that worried. The model course set the North back, huh?
What?
How much?
Oh, practically nothing. You know, Jerry, you get handsomer every day.
Oh, that bad, huh? Pam, how much?
A pittance, Jerry. A beggarly pittance. 16 lessons for only $300.
$300? Pittance? Look, a few pittances like that and we'll be the beggars. Did you pay for this course by check?
Yes, this afternoon.
All right, then get your hat. We're getting that check back right now.
Oh, but Jerry...
Your hat. Oh, look, I've gone along with a lot of things, but I'm absolutely darned if I'm going to pay $300 to learn how to fence with a book on your head.
¶¶
Touché. Oh, that's enough for tonight, Carl. I'm too rusty to be much competition.
You're always competition.
Oh, you are always gallant. I'll be in the office. I have some paperwork to do before evening classes. I can't tell you how much I appreciate this.
What is money when your mother is ill? Most important is that she get well.
Yes. And now, thanks to you, I'll be able to take care of her.
Yes. And soon, perhaps, I will have enough money to take care of you both.
But Jerry, the school teaches a lot of things besides walking with a book on your head.
Uh-huh.
Hi there.
This is Darlene. Her posture's bad.
Oh.
It is.
A what?
It is.
Oh, man, you're all alike.
Well, where is this dance? Hey, what gold?
Jerry, are you all right?
Oh, I guess so. Gee, they didn't have to get that mad just because I wanted the check back. Seriously, any idea who that was or what the...
Well, I think fencing outfit. He came from the office, I think.
The office? We better go see what it was he was so anxious to get away from.
Don Santiago. Is he?
Police headquarters? Give me homicide. Lieutenant Wagon, please.
Wagon speaking. Oh, hello, Jerry. What's on your mind? What? On the level? Okay, hang on. Just got a report of a homicide.
Where?
Don Santiago School for Models in the Morgan Building. Get a wagon out there right away. Garage?
Yes, sir.
Lieutenant Wagon, bring my car around.
Right.
You still there, Jerry? Yeah. Look, can you identify the body? Okay, hang on. Identification files?
Yes, sir.
Check on a man by the name of Santiago. Don Santiago.
Right.
Jerry, will you answer me one question? How do you and Pam do it? Strange weapon to find in a modeling school, isn't it?
Our curriculum includes fencing, but that's an épée, not a foil.
Well, Pam said the killer was in a fencing costume. Well, that narrows it down to someone in this school. Is there anyone missing who was around earlier?
No one.
How much money was taken?
$5,000, perhaps a little more. It was in a flat metal strongbox.
That's a lot of money.
Well, it was from a business transaction, the sale of some bonds. I'd been paid in cash and hadn't had time to get to the bank.
Now, apparently, Don Santiago had the safe open when the killer came in. He saw the money and took it the hard way with this épée, which doesn't look too easy to handle.
Oh, it is for Miss Loomis. She was a state champion. It doesn't take a champion to run through a defenseless man. All it takes is a killer.
You're the expert in these matters, I understand, Mr. Werner. What can you tell me about the weapon that was used to kill Don Santiago?
You may as well know now. It was my own personal épée, A dueling affair I've had ever since Heidelberg. It must have been stolen from my locker. It was stolen. I didn't kill him.
No one's accusing you, Mr. Werner.
I'll bet it was Ellen who took it. She takes everything else that doesn't belong to her.
That's a lie!
Ask any of the girls why we started locking our lockers.
You!
Oh, darling, you should...
Oh, you!
Hey, wait a minute. Come on. All right, now, come on, girls. Break it up.
I'm sorry, but I thought you ought to know the truth about her.
You.
Ellen, please...
I'm sorry, Lieutenant.
All right, now, all of you just be patient till I call a searching crew. And as soon as they get here and have a look around, you can all go home. Just to make sure you are patient. There are men stationed out in the hall and downstairs in the lobby.
I hope this will not take too long.
Not any longer than necessary, Mr. Werner. And in the meantime, I'd like to have a look at that locker where you kept the epee. All right, that's all for now. Be right with you. How's your head, Jerry?
Hard, thank goodness.
Bill, I have an idea.
Stop right there.
But I...
Pam, do you have any facts to add to what you already told me?
Well, not exactly facts, but can't I...
No, you can't. Pam, this time I want you and Jerry to stay out of trouble and stay out of my hair.
Well, Bill Wygant, if you think...
I think you're going to the office with Miss Loomis. I'll join you there later, and you can tell me your ideas then.
But, Bill, the murderer may get away
before...
No, no,
the killer didn't have time to get rid of the money. Now, we'll find it. And when we do, we'll have the killer.
Come on, Pam. Thank you, Bill.
My pleasure.
Oh.
All right, let's go.
Ellen.
Hmm?
I know who killed Santiago.
Do you?
Ellen, don't you understand? I saw you.
You saw me, but I didn't...
I saw you leave his office with a strong box. Ellen, you've got to let me help you.
Oh, Robert. I did take the money, but only to help out Daddy. Santiago gave it to me, Robert. I didn't kill him, I swear. Robert, you must believe me, I didn't kill him. I didn't even want to take the money, but I had to think of Daddy, and you didn't... I mean, you couldn't.
Sure, Ellen. But I think we'd better give the money back to Miss Loomis.
No, we can't. Robert, darling, don't you see? To admit that I have the money would make me be arrested for the murder.
Oh, but...
If you really want to help me, there's another way.
Anything, you know that, darling.
Then listen. Take the money out of here before the police have a chance to make the search.
What? But I can't. You heard Lieutenant Wygant. He has men stationed.
Well, then take it downstairs and hide it till later. Oh, please try.
All right, I'll try, darling. Only you'll have to help me. I can't...
I've been wondering, Lieutenant, will my epee be returned?
When it's through being Exhibit A in a murder trial.
Good. You may rest assured that I will never, never let it out of my sight again.
Yeah, someone may get hurt with it.
Come on, now's our chance. You stay here. I'll get the money. If anyone comes, call in to me to hurry.
Such a fine person. And so brave.
Just a minute, Mr. Hastings. What's in the bundle?
Nothing.
Nothing, huh? Let's see. The strong box. You're my boy. Lieutenant Wygant, he wants you. Did you hear what I said? Lieutenant Wygant wants to see you in the office. That's right, officer. I want you in here and bring that man with you. Here, I'll take this now. Let's go back into the office, Mr. Hastings. Personally, I can hardly wait to open this. Come on. right, let's go in the office. This is it, the missing cash box? Have you a key for it? Thank you. A check made out to Don Santiago, signed by Pam North. It's too bad you didn't have the opportunity to open the box and dispose of the check. $5,000, more or less, might have taken a little explanation on your part.
I have nothing to explain.
You mean you're willing to stand accused of the murder of Don Santiago? You'd be willing to sign a confession? What would you say? I'm interested.
I needed money.
I see. You sneaked in the office, cracked the safe. Santiago came in, you let him have it with the pay.
But Bill, he couldn't.
Please, Pam. Is that how it was done? You had no accomplice. You did this all by yourself. Robert, forget there's been a murder. Forget the money. Do you know that you could be arrested for what you're doing right now?
I... What do you mean?
You're lying, Hastings, through your pearly teeth. And I want to know why. Who are you protecting?
I'm not lying. I swear I...
Stop it. Before I validate your confession by making you open that safe where the money was kept. Could you do it? All right. Now, who was in this with you? Who would be wearing a fencing costume? And who would kill with an épée?
Going somewhere, Ellen? Oh, well, I saw the police had arrested Robert, so I thought it'd be all right.
All right for his accomplice to slip away?
But I'm not his accomplice.
Oh, Robert tried, darling. Give the wretched lad credit. He did his best to protect you. But that police lieutenant kept hammering at him. He's beginning to crack, Ellen. He'll be talking soon. And you know what he'll say.
But he can't. I didn't kill him.
You didn't, Ellen? Really? Well, do you expect the police to believe that when Robert tells him you gave him the money box stolen from the safe?
How do you know that? Unless
Don Santiago told me he'd given you the money. He did. He told me all about it, Ellen, how the two of you were going away. The West Coast, wasn't it?
You killed him.
Naturally. But then that's our secret, Ellen. Just between us girls. We girls can keep a secret when we're dead. And you're going to be dead.
They'll know. They'll know you did it.
Of course, I want them to. After all, there's some honor in capturing a murderess, an armed murderess, dead or alive. Especially when she tries to slash her way past me.
No!
You came to this school to learn, Mrs. North. You shall.
Jerry! Help! Jerry!
Miss Loomis, drop that knife.
Wait! She turned the blade, drove it against herself.
Jerry, get on the phone. Get a doctor and ambulance here right away.
You mean I'm not going to die?
Not this way, Miss Loomis.
Jerry, where did you put that magazine? Oh, no. No!
What do you mean, oh, no? Don't you want a model husband?
Jerry, I have news for you.
Huh? What?
Well, you know how you like to go all day Sundays without shaving? You hang on to all your old clothes and wear them whenever you can sneak out of the house in them.
Yeah.
You never hang anything up, never put anything away. And you rave about what other women wear and never notice my hats. Well?
Well?
Well, that's the model of the husband I married.
Spoiled, huh?
Mm-hmm. What's more, I'm going to keep you that way.
Thank you.
Mr. and Mrs. North is directed by Paul Landers. Produced by John W. Loveton. A John W. Loveton production. Starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning. Featuring Francis DeSales.